To make shearing much easier for the shearer and to encourage them to stay in the industry, it's important to have a ply board sheet that they can shear on and keep clean. What is a little bit more expensive but is necessary is a slatted floor. If the sheep are making a mess in the pen, they're getting their feet dirty, they're getting themselves dirty, but if they're kept up off that, where the muck goes down through the slatted floor, if you can see here, we have a slatted floor, the muck drops down through the dirt, and it keeps the sheep clean, the feet clean, and then it's some sort of controlled area. And as you can see, these sheep are controlled. They cannot get out, and the shearer can come in, pick his sheep up cleanly, he can bring it out onto the board, which Nick will do now. It's very safe, there's no nails, there's nothing he can really hurt himself on. But he brings the sheep out, controlled through the flat door. That shuts with a little spring here. Now you might, just before you start, Nick, you might think that that's quite expensive for one shearing, but you must remember you're shearing for the next maybe 20 years in the same place. So once this is set up, you've got it there, you can drench your sheep, you can check your sheep, you can use it for many reasons. But there's nobody going to get hurt, the sheep are not hurt, and it is in a controlled, clean environment. No sawdust, no straw. This belly wool needs to be pulled separate. So Nick can do this for us, really, because as he shears, we will gather up the belly wool like that and pass it out. Now that will go into this one. Now as you see, the sheep has got a little bit of dirt around the back end. So just take these bits out. As he cleans the tail, we'll just pull them out through the little dirty pieces. And the rest of the fleece should be complete. Nick is getting this wool off first time, which is very important. As he takes it off first time, you get the long stapled wool. And that is a complete piece of wool, the best price. And as you can see, the sheep is well shorn. The wool has come off in one go. Much better behaved sheep than the last one. But as you see this wool here now, there is no little short pieces. It's all long staples of wool. It's clean. I'm having one more look through to check. Just roll it around. There's a little bit of dirty wool. We'll put it to one side. We'll pick that up. And there is a spotless, clean, no straw, no sawdust, best price per pound. This has got involved, the black wool is involved. Now that black wool in there rolled up would be an absolute bad thing for the wool and for the price. So we need to make sure that when a black sheep has been shorn, it's clean, or just do this black sheep last, they do them first. So that goes in there. The belly wool, we have a bit of belly wool here. Now as you look on this fleece, it's very hard to keep them together, but I can see that is foreign. That doesn't belong there. It's separate, it's in a bundle. So if that comes in and goes in there, that will also reduce the price. So just pick that up. It should have been took out with the shearer. The shearer should have took the belly wool off, passed it over to a special place, and it's so easy to pick up and put somewhere else. That will be sold, but it will be sold in as belly wool, and there'll be a belly wool price. So there, you've took that out again, and it's the same thing. There is a bit of wool that is completely foreign to that fleece. You can see it is. So that would be took out. And after that, as long as you, everything is attached to the fleece, you roll the fleece up, and there she is. And hopefully it will be recognized that you get premium price for premium effort. If you don't put the effort in and you want straw and sawdust and muck and dirt in it, then that should be paid that degree. But if the wool is looked after, then it should have the best price.